Now, we will discuss some important terms. For example, term repo, long-term repo operations 1.0. Long-term repo operations 2.0. So there is a monetary policy tool which is called as liquidity adjustment facility. ठीक है, इसको हम क्या बोलते हैं? Liquidity adjustment facility बोलते हैं. So first of all, I would like to ask from all of you, are you getting the discussion? Are you able to understand? If you have any question, you can ask in the chat box. Or if you are able to understand everything, then please say yes in the chat box so that I get to know that you are actually getting the discussion. So there is a topic. So Nasreen is asking, sir, cover some basics too. My friend, I am discussing the basics, right? I am discussing the basics as much as possible. But if I discuss further, then this session will become too long and we will not be able to cover the current affairs. This session is primarily focusing on the current affairs. So allow me to please focus on the current affair. And definitely, if you want to understand the basic terms, you will find some lectures on the YouTube, or you can join the classes. I am providing those classes at a very affordable cost, right? Thank you. And for your understanding, I am discussing the basic concept. This slide is about basic concept only. Next few slides will be about basic concept only. So I will not leave the basic concept. I will give the background, right? Do not worry. So liquidity adjustment facility. Under this, there are two important aspects. One is repo rate. Another is reverse repo rate. And then we have third one, marginal standing facility. ठीक है? तो ये तीन चीजें हैं जो liquidity adjustment facility में आती हैं. ठीक है? First of all, what is the meaning of repo rate? Repo rate is basically, it is also called as the policy rate. It is the rate of interest at which RBI gives the short-term loan to the banks. ठीक है? And in return, the RBI also gets government securities, which will be repurchased by the banks later on. ठीक है? So there is a repurchase agreement. According to repurchase agreement, bank is selling the government security to the RBI. RBI is giving the loan in return to that. ठीक है? So this is the meaning of repo rate. This is the policy rate. And please tell me, what is the impact of repo rate increase or decrease? If repo rate is increased, what is the impact on the money supply and what is the impact on the inflation? Whether money supply will increase or decrease, please give the answer in the chat box. Money supply will basically decrease. Why? Because if the repo rate is increased, that means the commercial bank will also increase the rate of interest on which they will be giving the loan to the public. ठीक है? तो public भी ज्यादा rate of interest पे loan मिलेगा public को, और उसकी वजह से क्या होगा? Because of that, the public will get public will demand low money from the banks. ठीक है? Money supply will come down, inflation will also come down, right? And vice versa. So if the repo rate is decreasing, money supply will increase, inflation will also increase. ठीक है? Now please solve this question. So you have 30 seconds. Please give the answer in the chat box. ठीक है? So take your time. Be careful. this term repo is the current affair. That is why I'm discussing here. ठीक है? चलिए, सो आई कैन सी लॉट ऑफ आंसर्स. गुड, वेरी गुड, वंडरफुल. सो द आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन इज ऑप्शन ए ओनली. ठीक है, इसका जो आंसर है वो क्या है? ऑप्शन ए है. आंसर इज ऑप्शन ए ओनली. I will discuss the reason, right? First of all, what is the meaning of term repo? Term repo का मतलब क्या है? ठीक है? Term and repo. Repo you already know. This is a mechanism of repurchase agreement. ठीक है? Normally under the repo, overnight lending is done. So RBI gives the loan for overnight, सिर्फ एक दिन के लिए. ठीक है, this term basically means the duration of this loan is increased beyond one day. Right? Term means long term repo. एक तरह से this is a kind of long term repo, right? So this is a kind of long term repo. So here the duration is increased beyond one day. ठीक है, because the duration is more than one day, the rate of interest will also be different, right? So rate of interest is not equal to repo rate, it is more than basically repo rate. And what is the mechanism how this interest rate is decided? So the mechanism of auction is used. So those banks who want to take the loan from the RBI under this mechanism, they can participate in the auction and they can quote how much interest they can give. So they can compete with each other, and those banks who offer high rate of interest, they will get the loan. ठीक है, तो जो भी bank high rate of interest offer करेगा RBI को, उसको loan मिल जाएगा. ठीक है, give me a second. So can you see, can you listen? Rainfall. आपको आवाज आ रही होगी हल्की हल्की रेनफॉल की. बहुत अच्छी बारिश हो रही है बाहर. चलिए, तो रेपो रेट से ज्यादा होगा और ऑप्शन में पार्टिसिपेट करना होगा. दैट मींस दीज रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट विल बी फ्लेक्सिबल और वेरिएबल. ठीक है, तो ये फ्लेक्सिबल या वेरिएबल होगा, इट विल नॉट बी द फिक्स्ड रेट. ये फिक्स्ड रेट नहीं होगा. ठीक है, सो आर यू गेटिंग द पॉइंट? इट विल नॉट बी अ फिक्स्ड रेट, इट विल बी द फ्लेक्सिबल रेट. Now you can read here. So this mechanism of term repo was introduced as part of the liquidity adjustment facility in addition to the existing repo, reverse repo and MSF. The term repo means repo of more than 1 day duration. Since the loan is for more duration, bank should give high rate of interest than the repo. It is also called as variable rate repo because interest rate is varied depending upon the auction rate, right? So there is a mechanism of auction. The repo can have different durations, 7 days, 14 days, 28 days, right? So it can have different durations. So if we see the answer to this question, statement one is right and statement two is wrong. So answer is option A, statement one only, right? If anyone has any question on this, please ask on the chat box. Agar aapko koi sawal hai, to chat box mein aap pooch sakte ho. So this session will go on till 12:30, right? This session will go on till 12:30. Because of the disruption, we have to extend the time. Otherwise, I will try to keep it up to 70 to 75 minutes. ठीक है? तो मेरी कोशिश रहेगी कि आपके छोटे-छोटे सेशन हो, आपके जो खुद की स्टडी है, उसको डिस्टर्ब ना करे। उस आपके खुद के स्टडी के जो शेड्यूल है, उसी शेड्यूल के अंदर आप इन लेक्चर्स को देख लो, आपको कोई एक्स्ट्रा टाइम ना लगाना पड़े। That is my effort. That is my commitment. ठीक है? चलिए नाउ लेट अस डिस्कस द नेक्स्ट वन दैट इज अ लॉन्ग टर्म रेपो ऑपरेशंस राइट लॉन्ग टर्म रेपो ऑपरेशंस सो लॉन्ग टर्म इट इज वेरी वेरी क्लियर द ड्यूरेशन ऑफ दिस लोन्स इज लॉन्ग टर्म व्हेन आई से लॉन्ग टर्म इट इज अप टू 3 years इसकी जो ड्यूरेशन होती है वो क्या होती है 3 साल तक की ड्यूरेशन होती है ठीक है लेट अस सी द बेसिक्स अबाउट दिस सो इट इज अ न्यू टूल रिसेंट टूल व्हिच हैज बीन इंट्रोड्यूस्ड बाय द आरबीआई अंडर व्हिच द लोन कैन बी गिवन फ्रॉम 1 year टू 3 year टू द शेड्यूल्ड बैंक्स एट द प्रिवेलिंग रेपो रेट प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड दिस इज नॉट एट द flexible rate this long term repo operations are conducted at the fixed rate right so these are different from the term repo although this is a variant of the term repo only this is a variant of the term repo ye term repo ka hi ek alag version hai lekin iske andar jo rate of interest hota hai wo fixed rate hota hai and that is equal to repo rate theek hai uska jo रेट है वो क्या होता है रेपो रेट होता है और ऐसा क्यों है व्हाई दीज आर प्रोवाइडेड एट द रेपो रेट द पर्पस इज दैट ऑल द बैंक कैन गेट द अपॉर्चुनिटी टू गेट दिस टाइप ऑफ लोन द पर्पस इज टू इंक्रीज द शॉर्ट टर्म लिक्विडिटी इन द मार्केट अप टू 3 years ठीक है तो द आरबीआई वांट्स दैट ऑल द बैंक्स शुड गेट द इक्वल अपॉर्चुनिटी दे शुड बी एबल टू गेट द लोन एट सेम रेट एंड the loan should be available in the market right so purpose is to provide the durable liquidity to assure the scheduled commercial banks that there is a availability of durable liquidity between 1 year to 3 year at the reasonable rate to hum rate of interest bhi zyada nahi karenge agar rate of interest zyada ho jayega to hamara long term repo operation ka purpose defeat ho jayega kyunki what is the purpose of long term repo operation the purpose is to increase money supply right if we increase the rate of interest the money supply will not increase so if we keep this rate high then the purpose of the loan will be defeated theek hai the purpose is to bring down short term market interest rate which are charged by the scheduled commercial bank so that they can invest into the corporate bonds wo corporate bond mein invest kar sake And ultimately, the economic growth can improve. When more money will be available to the people, then they can increase the production. And when they can increase the production, then there will be economic growth. ठीक है? Now, targeted long-term repo operations, right? So, जो last वाला था वो क्या था? Long-term repo operation, LTRO. This is targeted long-term repo operations, TLTRO, right? Here, what is the meaning of word targeted? Targeted का मतलब क्या है? Targeted means it is targeted at particular sectors. ये particular sectors के लिए targeted है. For example, it can be for corporates, or it can be for MSMEs, or it can be for NBFC, right? So the meaning of the word targeted is that under this mechanism, RBI is targeting particular sectors. RBI want to increase money supply in those particular sectors. That is why this term targeted has been used. ठीक है जी? तो यहाँ पर targeted का मतलब है that RBI want to target particular sectors. RBI particular sectors को target करना चाहता है. So these targeted long-term repo operations, these were conducted in the month of March 2020. March 2020 में इनको हमने conduct किया था, worth 25,000 crore. Under this, the word targeted means scheduled commercial banks have to deploy the funds. So जो भी पैसा scheduled commercial bank को मिलता है, they have to use that money for buying specified security. So they have to invest that money in buying specific securities. These securities can be corporate bond. That means it is a kind of loan which will be given to the corporate companies को loan दिया जाएगा एक तरह से. ठीक है? Commercial paper is also a loan instrument which can be issued by the corporate, जो corporate द्वारा issue किया जा सकता है. ठीक है? So it is also kind of corporate loan. So the target is basically corporates. Third, non-convertible debentures. Debentures are also the loan instrument. What is the meaning of non-convertible? Non-convertible means those debentures which are not convertible into the equity shares. ठीक है? तो the word convertible means there's those debentures which can be converted into the equity shares. So from loan, it becomes capital. From loan, it is converted into the capital. Non-convertible means it does not convert into the capital. It remains a loan. So these are the three areas where this money will be utilized. These will be the target. ये क्या रहेंगे? Target रहेंगे. ठीक है? The tenure of the loan will be up to 3 years. And please see carefully. ठीक है? ध्यान से देखो. Just like टर्म रेपो की तरह यहां पर भी फ्लोटिंग रेट होगा. रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट विल नॉट बी फिक्स्ड. सो अनलाइक एलटीआरओ, हियर द रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट इज फ्लेक्सिबल, राइट? तो माय फ्रेंड्स, इट डिपेंड्स अपॉन द डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ आरबीआई वेदर आरबीआई वांट टू कीप इट फ्लेक्सिबल और वेरिएबल. ठीक है? तो डिपेंडिंग अपॉन every operation, that is every transaction, RBI can decide whether rate of interest is going to be flexible or it is going to be fixed, right? There is no there is no fixed formula, there is no predefined formula that this long term repo operation will be at what rate. So normally RBI keeps it fixed, but from operation to operation it can change also. Operation to operation RBS को change भी कर सकती है. ठीक है? अगर scheduled commercial bank condition को satisfy नहीं करते हैं, तो they have to pay the penal rate. They have to give high rate of interest. Now, after this, so the first LTR was conducted in March 2020 and the second LTR was conducted on 17th April 2020, right? So we are basically under the corona lockdown situation. During the corona lockdown, the RBI introduced LTRO 1.0. RBI wanted to infuse liquidity in the market, but RBI noticed that most of the money has actually gone into the public sector entities and large corporates. So, jo zyadatar paisa hai, the money of the LTRO 1.0 has actually gone to the government companies and to the big companies. So, those companies which are small and mid-sized and NBFC, non-banking financial companies, microfinance institutions, they did not get sufficient money, right? So big companies and PSUs, they got a lot of money, but small companies, NBFC, MFIs, they did not get sufficient money. Now my question is, let me test your knowledge, right? So be prepared. What is the meaning of primary market? And what is the difference between the primary market and the secondary market? So please take 5 seconds and think. So these sessions are going to be learning packed. I don't want to make it monotonous. I want that you also have some thought process. So you can give the answer in the chat box if you want to give the answer. What is the difference between the primary market and the secondary market? My friends, these questions can be asked anytime. ठीक है, तो question जरूरी नहीं है कि TLTRO पे आएगा, हो सकता है question primary market और secondary market पे आ जाए, you never know. Okay, so primary market, and in the primary market, the bond issuer or the company sells the bond directly to the investor. ठीक है, so this is the first time issue or first time sale of the bond or share kisi bhi cheez ka. Theek hai, for example Reliance is issuing the bond, so Reliance is issuing the bond in the market, anyone can go and anyone can buy from the Reliance. So this transaction happens between the bond issuer or issuer of the equity share and the investor. In the secondary market, the same bond which was purchased from the Reliance, it can be exchanged between two investors, investor one and investor two, right? So in this case, the transaction is happening between the investor one and investor two. Suppose this investor is the investor one. Investor one purchased the bond from the company, Reliance company. Now he want to encash this bond, he want to sell this bond, but Reliance company will not accept this bond before a certain time. Reliance company has issued this bond for a fixed period of time, maybe 5 year, 10 year or perpetual, which has no expiry date, right? So investor one can sell these shares in the secondary market. So in the secondary market, the transaction happened between the two investor, and in the primary market, the transaction happened between the investor and the money getter. Okay, what is the difference between the NBFC and the banks? Now next question, what are the points of difference between the NBFC and the banks? Bank or NBFC ke beech mein kya points of difference hote hain? What are the important points of difference? So you can write just one point, that will be more than sufficient. Give the answer in the chat box. I want that you get strong hold over the basics also, relevant basics. ठीक है, तो मैं कोशिश करूंगा कि आपके जो conceptual clarity है वो हमारे sessions में बढ़े. These sessions are not going to be purely factual. These concepts are going to be kind of revisionary session, thought provoking sessions. तो मैं चाहता हूं कि आप लोग answer दो. What is the difference between the NBFC and the bank? I'm not getting any answer. My friends, this is not done. If you are not able to participate, how will I know whether you are getting them or not? And you just need to type in a single line, write a single point. Just sirf ek point type karo. Kya difference hai NBFC aur bank ke beech mein? Okay, Shivam is not able to recall. Give any answer, my friends. If you are not able to recall, say that. I will discuss, not an issue. Good. So Rishabh has given good answer. NBFC do not accept demand deposit. Yes. So the first point of difference between the NBFC and bank is NBFC cannot accept. NBFC cannot accept demand deposit. They cannot accept the deposit below 12 month. वो एक साल से कम की डिपॉजिट एक्सेप्ट नहीं कर सकते. दे कैन एक्सेप्ट ओनली टर्म डिपॉजिट और टाइम डिपॉजिट. ठीक है, दिस इज द फर्स्ट पॉइंट ऑफ डिफरेंस. द सेकेंड पॉइंट ऑफ डिफरेंस इज दैट दे हैव टू ऑफर द रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट. दे हैव टू ऑफर द रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट टू द कस्टमर एट अ मिनिमम लेवल, राइट? एंड दैट मिनिमम लेवल इज डिसाइडेड बाय द आरबीआई. तो आरबीआई एक मिनिमम लेवल ऑफ इंटरेस्ट डिफाइन करता है और उस मिनिमम रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट से कम ये लोग इंटरेस्ट नहीं दे सकते. ठीक है. थर्ड, एनबीएफसी डू नॉट पार्टिसिपेट इन द पेमेंट एंड सेटलमेंट सिस्टम. एनबीएफसी डू नॉट पार्टिसिपेट इन द पेमेंट एंड सेटलमेंट सिस्टम. सो अनलाइक बैंक, बैंक पार्टिसिपेट इन द पेमेंट एंड सेटलमेंट सिस्टम. इफ यू इशू द चेक ऑफ पंजाब नेशनल बैंक एंड डिपॉजिट in the State Bank of India, State Bank of India will deposit the money in your account and get the money from the PNB. So this transaction happens with the help of payment and settlement system. But in case of NBFC, this facility is not available. ठीक है, ये facility available नहीं है. Good. So are you getting the concept? Did you get the difference between the bank and the NBFC? Please say yes. At least say why. Right? You can write just why in the chat box. ठीक है? अगर आपको time save करना है, if you are being lazy, you can write why. But I need at least one answer from everyone. I want to have this session interactive. This session is not going to be one-way session. This session is going to be two-way session. I want you to participate. Please participate. Okay, great. Now, my next question is, who is the regulator of NBFC? So you will be getting thought provoking questions, and those people who have attended my sessions, Venkatesh, Divya, I am expecting answer from you. First of all, is there only one regulator or more than one regulator? Yes. So there can be different regulator. There are certain NBFC which are regulated by the RBI. There are certain NBFC which are regulated by the IRDA, the insurance companies. Insurance companies are also the NBFC. So IRDA is the regulator of the insurance companies, right? RBI is the regulator of NBFC like microfinance institution, like this IL&FS, जो आपने crisis हुआ था उसमें, ठीक है? So they are multiple regulators. Even this National Housing Bank, it also controls some certain NBFCs. Okay. So please read from the basic, revise the basic also. Hai na? So do you also want to have a revisionary session of the economy? जिसमें मैं फटाफट revise करवा सकूँ आपको पूरा economy. Do you want to have these sessions also? I will try to complete entire economy in just 25 hours. 25 hours में पूरी economy complete, पूरा revision, nothing else. All the important point discussed. On the fast space. Okay, but that I will have after the current affairs are complete. After that I will start, and before that I need certain commitments from you. You need to come here daily at 11 a.m. ठीक है? So यूट्यूब काम नहीं कर रहा है, हम लोग जूम पे ये सेशन कंटिन्यू करेंगे, आपको जूम की आईडी मैं शेयर कर दूंगा, ठीक है, आपको जूम की आईडी शेयर हो जाएगी, आप जूम पे आइए और डेली 11 बजे ये सेशन अटेंड कीजिए, ये आपसे कमिटमेंट चाहिए। ओनली इफ आई गेट सर्टेन नंबर ऑफ पीपल आई विल बी एबल टू कंटिन्यू फ्री क्लासेस, अदरवाइज आई कैन नॉट प्रोवाइड द फ्री क्लासेस, ठीक है। मैं फ्री क्लास तभी दूंगा अगर आप आ करके डेली ये सेशन यहाँ पर अटेंड करोगे। ओनली इफ यू आर अटेंडिंग लाइव क्लासेस देन ओनली आई विल नॉट गिव द रिकॉर्डेड क्लासेस अदरवाइज, ठीक है। चलिए, थैंक यू एवरीवन, वंडरफुल। सो नाउ नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ माइक्रो फाइनेंस इंस्टीट्यूशंस? सो दिस माइक्रो फाइनेंस इंस्टीट्यूशंस दे आर द एनबीएफसी, ठीक है, ये क्या होती है, एनबीएफसी होती है। Tell me one point. How do we identify that it is a microfinance institution? What is the meaning of microfinance? Just microfinance ka matlab bata do mujhe. Anyone? So we have around 14 people right now. Who will tell? Kaun batayega? Out of 14 people, at least one person can tell. What is the meaning of microfinance? First of all, it is low amount of lending. So it is the size of loan. It is the size of loan. ये size of loan के बारे में हम बात कर रहे हैं। तो microfinance is basically talking about the size of loan. ठीक है? तो ये हम size of loan के बारे में बात कर रहे हैं। And there is a news about this. How much is the size of loan which can be given by the microfinance institution? So earlier it was 1 lakh rupees. Pehle ye kitna tha? 1 lakh rupees tha. Now this is also a current affair. My friends, I am trying to cover the current affairs in every slide from every point of view. These microfinance institutions earlier, those institutions which were giving the loan up to 1 lakh rupees, they were classified as the micro loan. Now this limit has been increased to 1.5 lakh. Are you getting? This time this loan has in, this limit has been increased to 1.25 lakh, and this is with effect from October 19 se ये आपका स्टार्ट हुआ है, ठीक है। सो दिस इज ऑल्सो करंट अफेयर, दिस इज ऑल्सो वन करंट अफेयर, वी विल डिस्कस दिस करंट अफेयर अगेन इन द सेशन ऑफ मनी एंड कैपिटल मार्केट। हम मनी एंड कैपिटल मार्केट में इसको अलग से डिस्कस करेंगे, बट आई एम डिस्कसिंग हियर ऑल्सो, ठीक है। सो नाउ कमिंग बैक टू द TLTRO, इन द TLTRO 1, द मैक्सिमम अमाउंट वेंट टू द पब्लिक सेक्टर एंटरप्राइजेस एंड द लार्ज कॉर्पोरेट। तो ज्यादातर पैसा कहां चला गया? बड़ी कंपनी के पास में और सेंट्रल पीएसयू के पास में। इसलिए आरबीआई केम अप विद एलटीएलटीआरओ 2.0, दैट इज व्हाई आरबीआई केम अप विद द टीएलटीआरओ 2.0। इसलिए आरबीआई को टीएलटीआरओ 2.0 के लिए आना पड़ा, ठीक है। Yeah. So TLTRO 2.0, under this 50,000 crore of the fund will be given, and it will be invested in the bonds, commercial papers, and non-convertible debentures on the of the NBFC. Ye NBFC mein paisa jayega. This money will go to the NBFC, and out of this 50% of the NBFC. Out of this 50% of the NBFC loan will be going to the small and mid-sized NBFC and microfinance institution. So this is a limit of 1.25 lakh, right?